I said, my God, if you want these gentlemen to all get together, ladies, to be able to perform, they need to feel your energy. Speaking of energy, we've had a request if some people could put their umbrellas down. We know it's hot and stuff, but others can't see. So just for a little public service announcement, we've been asked to address that. So welcome to the East Elm Meadow Rotary Summer Concert Series. This is the fourth concert in our lineup of eight concerts as we celebrate the 32nd annual Summer Concert Series. Now you may ask, what happened to the third concert? Good question. We had excellent guidance from WWLP meteorologists, and it was a complete dangerous situation last Wednesday and Thursday. We have asked the band, we have an emergency rain date, if there was any possibility that they might be able to make it. Kenny checked. Unfortunately, two members can't make it on the Wednesday, and another two couldn't make it on the Thursday. So unfortunately, they won't be back, but we will have an eighth concert. It will be tacked on to the end of our concert series, which will be a really great surprise. We'll tell you more about that next week. But we tried, Kenny and his band tried, it just couldn't be done, and it was too dangerous on both of those days. Now tonight, we have spectacular news here. And speaking of news, you want to know that WWLP 22 News and the CW Springfield are our sponsors for tonight. And as one of their representatives, I have asked our fabulous MC, Cy Becker, if he would come on and say a few words on behalf of our sponsors tonight.
I love talking about 22 News. You know, you probably are asking, why are we here on the grass and not up on the stage? Oh, you haven't heard the real reason yet. I walked up to Sam Falsetti and said, Sam, can we do this from the stage? He said, do you play the accordion? I said, no, you don't get up on the stage. So that is why we are not up on the stage today. 22 News and the East Long Meadow Rotary Club Concert Series have been together for 32 years. It is wonderful. What an experience this has been. To be your weather people, to make it possible for all of you to come out here, see these magnificent concerts, and play a role in it. And that's what we are at 22 News. We are your community station. I must tell you, this is a little experience we had today. A lady called from the town of Wendell, that's up in Franklin County, and she said, I have a story for you. And I asked her, you're giving this story to everyone? And she said, no, we're giving it to you. I asked her why. We're giving you this story because you come here. We come to East Long Meadow, we come to Wendell, and we feel appreciated. And that's why we're here tonight. And Sue, thank you very much. 32 years and counting. We'll be back again next year, I guarantee you. And thank all of you, the people who come here every single week and who support these concerts. And of course, those who depend on Mr. Lapis for the weather. Because if Mr. Lapis said it's raining, you wouldn't be here tonight, would you? So it's great to have all of you here. And this is another great occasion that 22 News can help support. 32 years, I love that.
All right, what I want to do also is to have a big round of applause for our fellow Rotarians. We've had Al Grimaldi, Marcus as our stage manager, on the field, Linda Livingstone, John Tarbell. We've had them on the field since noontime, getting everything all set up, and you know how hot it was, so we want to take that extra time. Also, our fellow Rotarians that are working in the concession stand. It's hot in there, but they want to make sure that everything is all right for you, and they are ready. Now, speaking of being ready, Cy, if you will make this next announcement.
Sue, I will be very happy. This is an annual event. For those of you who do not know what the Paul Harris Award means, it's one of the highest honors, if not the highest honor, one Rotarian can give to the community. And we're going to introduce right now the chairman of the Paul Harris Committee, Rotarian Bob Frater. Bob!
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. So we're really honored tonight to have a new person we're going to be appointing as a Paul Harris Fellow. And Paul Harris was the guy that started Rotary way back hundreds of years ago in Chicago. And that's why we have the name Paul Harris. So we're very proud that we're able to make these awards every year, and we contribute money to the Paul Harris Fellow organizations, and then as a result of that, we're allowed to make these presentations. So we do have a great presentation this evening, and should I just announce who it is? Okay. Roll the runs, please. Okay, it is Amber Boucher. And if Amber, right over here, if you would just walk right down, that'll be great. Amber's done a lot of work for our club. She's been doing work for us for over, I don't know, 10 years it looks like, helping out here and doing some work all around. And you may know more about it than I do because you're watching, and maybe you'd like to say a few words.
Yes, Amber takes her job very seriously. You do not go up to the concession stand if you're a Rotarian and just want to waste her time chit-chatting. She's got a job to do. She does it very well. She's very focused and dedicated, a hard worker, and we appreciate Amber so much. So I will turn it back over so Amber, you'll be able to get your award.
Well, if you can hang on to that, I'm going to hand out the awards. Okay, so the first award is simply a thing that you're going to put around your neck, or maybe your. And then we have a pin, if I can find it. There we are. Let me just get that out of here. Maybe you can.
And we will introduce Amber's father, Michael Boucher. Of course, he's a Rotarian that has been here for more years than I have. And he works real hard, helps to set up the band shell along with Bob Hill, and a lot of work. And when you see the 4th of July parade, he's there. So now he will pin his daughter. He's used to working with heavy-duty machines, not these tiny, delicate things.
Okay. And then the last thing we have is the actual award itself. And maybe Dad would like to read that.
He says, the Rotary Foundation of Rotary International, Amber Boucher, is hereby named Paul Harris Fellow in appreciation for tangible and significant assistance given to the furtherance and the better understanding of friendly relationships among people of the world. Congratulations,
Dan. All right, there you go. Congratulations.
One more round. Great job. Okay. Amber, thank you so much, and we appreciate all your help through all these years. And we're so proud of you, and we wanted to publicly recognize you. All right. All right, thank you all very much. One more hand for Amber Boucher, and thank you, Bob, our Paul Harris chairman. Now, going back to our MC, Cy Becker.
So we have one more announcement to make before we introduce the New England Digital Accordion Orchestra, and that is we want to move ahead to August the 1st. I believe it is Tuesday, the first Tuesday in August. This entire area will be taken up with the pride of East Longmeadow. It's the National Night Out, when people come to see what their police department do, and along with the fire department, they will have shows. It will be the kind of event that makes you proud to live in East Longmeadow. And even if you don't live in East Longmeadow and you come here, it should make you proud. It's people coming together to celebrate their community. And now, ladies and gentlemen, even though I have not been invited up on the stage, you are going to hear music like you have never heard before. Is that right, Sam? Music like you have never heard before. This is their debut before an East Longmeadow Rotary Club concert audience, the New England Digital Accordion Orchestra, led by Sam Falsetti. Sam, take it away.
Just become, you're on their way to becoming friends of the orchestra by the time this is over. I'm Bob Datz, I am a friend of the orchestra, and you're in for several concerts this evening, all for the price of zero. So you're gonna get your money's worth and more, because this orchestra and these digital accordions are going to unveil for you everything from Broadway musicals to pop, as you just heard, disco, as you just heard, I should say, special stylings of vocalist Eddie Young, who's going to be joining us, and he's come all the way from West Palm Beach, Florida, to do that, by the way, and a lot of other favorites. You're going to find things you like, and you're going to find new things you're going to love. These digital accordions are pretty amazing. You've gotten a taste of it already. A single player can devote each hand to a different instrument. You put 24 of these on stage, and you've got the real deal for an orchestra. Everything from banjo or violin or viola on the string side to flute, from flute to oboe, you name it. Nothing to put down or pick up. They're playing the same amazing box. It's way beyond the old electric organ as far as the quality of it. They can really push out the kind of accents that musicians do, and you're gonna hear a ton of that tonight. If Sam Falsetti's name is familiar, he's the guy who started this orchestra. He also started Falsetti Music in Springfield, and what he has in common with Cy Becker is a never-ending zest for what they do, and you're seeing that tonight as well. So these instruments, used by big-time musicians of all types, you're going to get a great sampling tonight. If I Were a Rich Man and Fiddler on the Roof are two songs from the blockbuster show Fiddler on the Roof, and who knew that this took its inspiration, you probably heard of the Rothschilds. If I Were a Rich Man was originally written as If I Were a Rothschild. Anyway, enjoy these two classics together from the musical Fiddler on the Roof. ¶¶ You're getting the idea. These guys came together, these men and women came together in 2013, and they are refining this sound, and it's more amazing the variety of things that they do. We're going to go from one ethnic flavored music to another favorite flavored ethnic music. That is Napoli. The Neapolitan Memories is a collection of the most beautiful songs from Napoli, compiled and arranged by John Francis Cina. Come back to Sorrento, O Sole Mio. Funiculi, funicula. You know them, you love them. You can move your body with them. The New England Digital Accordion Orchestra. Thank you. My goodness. Neapolitan memories. You know, when we talk about listening carefully and you can hear all these other instruments being played by these accordions, if you really listened on this one, you didn't have to listen too hard. You actually heard accordions sounding like accordions because that's the Napoli sound. While we're traveling to far-off places, why not shoot for the moon? Fly Me to the Moon, recorded a few times by many different people, some great ones like Lawrence, Tony Bennett and Doris Day. But when you get to Frank Sinatra, you say, well, that's what you identify this song with, Frank Sinatra and Count Basie. But now, tonight, and for now and forevermore, you can identify this song with Eddie Young, who's going to join us in his own unique stylings. Fly Me to the Moon.
Fly me to the moon. Let me play among the stars. Let me see what spring is like on Jupiter and Mars. In other words, hold my hand. In other words, baby, kiss me. Fill my heart with song. Let me sing forevermore. Yes, you are all I long for, all I worship and adore. In other words, please be true. In other words,
those ball players behind us didn't know it, but Eddie just knocked it out of the park.
Yeah.
Excellent. You know, we talk about this being the New England Digital Accordion Orchestra, and you're thinking, well, you know, how far are you going to drive to come play an accordion in East Longmeadow? Well, in some cases, pretty far. This is the New England Digital Accordion Orchestra with emphasis on New England, starting with Eddie Young, who is coming from West Palm Beach, but also has a home in New London. He is part of our Connecticut contingent, along with Bob Zarnecki of Colchester, Connecticut, and John Kalinowski from Portland, Connecticut. So let's give them a little hand for making the trek from the Constitution State. It's hard to forget the Pink Panther theme. It gets in your head, and you're walking around with it all day long. But that might happen again tonight if you haven't heard it for a while. We're going to have a solo by Jim Avedisian of Millbury, Mass. And he performs around Central Mass in assisted living facilities, restaurants, and other places. He's former Vice President of Mass Accordion Association. He loves to play, as you're going to be able to tell. Let's listen to the Pink Panther theme song. Thank you.
I think we could all use a little cooling down, and we're getting it slowly. If we think about the Nutcracker and we think about that time of year, maybe we can kind of help cool off a little bit. So Overture Miniature brings to life the Nutcracker, which was a two-act ballet performed first in 1892 in St. Petersburg, Russia. Now, Overture Miniature.
I know that my mama don't dance. Does your mama dance? In 1972, she might have, and that's when this was a huge hit. By Loggins and Messina, not only hit the top 10 on the charts, but it's been covered by everybody from Poison to Elvis Presley. So we're going to have Eddie Young again add his name to the history of this song with the New England Digital Accordion Orchestra. Your Mama Don't Dance. Your mic don't dance on stage left.
One.
We just wanted to make you run.
Do we? Speaking of great polka musicians, any Weird Al Yankovic fans here tonight? Well, Frankie Yankovic is going to have to do, okay? So his Pennsylvania Polka, one of Frankie Yankovic and the Yanks' greatest hits, not to say anything bad about Weird Al. It was actually part of the Groundhog Day movie soundtrack, and it really captures what polka is all about. So if you want to show that with your arms, legs, feet, and torsos, come right on. Pennsylvania Polka.
Thank you.
know, Sam has been doing this for 60 years, this accordion thing. He started going door to door offering lessons on accordion out in Westfield. He met Peggy, his wife, that way. It must have paid off. Falsetti Music's been in business. It's just been great. So that's Roots Accordion right there. Have anybody here ever gone out, you forgot your keys, you got to go back in the house, you forgot your wallet, you got to go back in the house? 80 years after our country was founded, they said, oh, we forgot something. We've got slaves. So there was a war. And it was a tragedy, really, and it disunited people in this country. But what actually they had in common was what we all have in common, which is music. And music is a motivator, either way. So from way down south, from Dixie to New England, to the songs of the North, Battle Hymn of the Republic, we're going to ask you to join in at some point here in a medley, with your voices, of course, in a medley that we call Conflict, remembering our nation's Civil War.
Thank you. Hallelujah.
I got to tell you, I forgot to tell you that, and you probably saw the folks stand up at the beginning of the song. That wasn't the drummer doing the drums at the beginning of the song. That was one hand on the accordion. Speaking of bringing North and South together, by the way, I'm not talking about North and South long metal. We've got our Rhode Island contingent here in the orchestra and our New Hampshire contingent. Uniting, right, for us and for you. Guy Lumberry of Providence, Rhode Island is here. Diane Queerbach of Milford, New Hampshire. Let's welcome them. Of course, they drive up here for practice too, and they probably ask themselves, what am I doing? But now you're gonna see what they're doing once again. This orchestra, by the way, available for your backyard parties, weddings, bar mitzvahs, cookouts, and things you don't wanna even tell anybody about. See Sam Falsetti or contact Falsetti Music. When we introduce I've Got You Under My Skin, I know you're out here on the lawn. We're not asking you to check for ticks. This is a classic, as you know. Frank Sinatra probably brings it to mind. It's written by Cole Porter. Let's bring back Eddie Young for I've Got You Under My Skin. Somebody didn't transpose, and it wasn't me. And it wasn't any of you. That is a change of key, which can be accomplished on these instruments fairly quickly, and we're going to try it again. We've got a high bar here.
This affair never gonna go so well. But why should I try to resist it? Darling, it know damn well I've got you under my skin. I'd sacrifice anything, come what might, for the sake of having you near. Spite of that warning voice, it comes in the night and repeats and yells in my ear. Don't you know, you fool, you're never gonna win. Use your mentality, wake up to reality. time that I do. Just the thought of you makes me stop before I begin. Ooh, I've got you under my skin. 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 This is my trombone. Sacrifice anything, come what might, for the sake of having you near. In spite of that warning voice, it comes in the night, and it yells and it screams in my ear. Don't you know, you old fool, you're never gonna win. Why not use your mentality? Wake up, step up to reality. Yes, each time that I do, just the thought of you makes me stop before I begin. Ooh, I've got you under my skin. And I love you under my skin. Boom, 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 boom.
So now you had the sun before, and we were in the shade, and now you're in the shade, and we've got the sun. But we've got the power. All right. We're going to bring Bob Mazzagalla and Guy Lambari into the spotlight right now for a duet in Gentilisa Waltz. Guy comes to us from Providence, Bob from Pittsfield. They're meeting halfway, and this is a natural for the accordion, but I'm sure you're going to find some surprises lurking in the background. Get up and dance, if you wish, with the Gentilisa Waltz.
Thank you.
doesn't get any better on a summer night. And by the way, the sunset is brought to you tonight by the East Longmeadow Rotary Club. So let's give them a hand for putting that on. We wait all winter for summer. We wait all through the hot day for a nice summer night like this. That kind of reminded me of being on the carousel, maybe Mountain Park. Speaking of Americana, John Philip Sousa and his Stars and Stripes Forever is about as starsy and stripesy and Americana as it gets. It's a mover. Feel free to join in the movement as we hear Stars and Stripes Forever. Songs. In the case of Tie a Yellow Ribbon, which is not as old of tradition, that was a worldwide hit only in 1973, but it was initially a love song, okay? And then some things happened in the world, and we came together with this song remembering some people who were held hostage, and the yellow ribbon came to mean something else. So together through the good times and the bad times with our music is what keeps us going. This was Tony Orlando and Dawn. Now, it's Eddie Young and the New England Digital Accordion Orchestra. Tie a Yellow Ribbon.
I'm coming home, I've done my time. Now I've got to know what is and isn't mine. If you receive my letter telling you I'd soon be free. Then you'll know just what to do if you still want me. If you still want me. Tie your yellow ribbon round the old oak tree. It's been 3 long years. Do you still want me? If I don't see a ribbon round the old oak tree, I'll stay on the bus, forget about us, put the blame on me. If I don't see a ribbon round the old tree.
To sing in the theme from Rocky, there's only 30 words. So in this case, the music definitely overshadowed the lyrics in terms of what people remember about Rocky, which is just what they don't want to be doing 5:30 in the morning, running upstairs wearing sweat clothes, and they left that to Sylvester Stallone. He did just fine with it. So we're going to hear it now. The piece is actually called Gonna Fly Now, so let's do it.
Thank you.
Virtuoso in the house, Billy? Where's Angela setting up? I figured. I saw some activity over there, but I couldn't quite see her. All right, Angela Falsetti, 12 years old. And that means, let's see, Sam's been doing this for 5 of her lifetimes. But that ratio will decrease as she gets older, okay? She's already pushing her own musical agenda here, and you're going to hear that right now in this musical family, the granddaughter of Sam and Peggy, and Michael's daughter, who's playing with us here in the band. So, she is going to be working with Datastick. That's where her orchestration's coming from, because it's the 21st century, kids. And that's how it's happening. So she's going to be playing with her role and instrument, and she's going to put to use all those music lessons and put it all out in her own way, adding some vocals at the same time in a piece called Free For All. Angela? Since then. It won him a Grammy Award, but he probably did not envision being covered by the New England Digital Accordion Orchestra, because in 1980, who could envision a digital accordion? Well, we can. Let's listen to On the Road Again. Trivia question. Win a drink, win a bet, fool your friends. Who is the first woman composer to win an Oscar for her composition? 3, 2, 1. Barbara Streisand. Of course, all the Barbara Streisand fans knew that. A Star is Born is the theme from the 1976 movie Evergreen, and it won an Academy Award for her, as well as lyricist Paul Williams. So, are we ready? Evergreen it is.
Thank you.
thank you by Sam saying that if you couldn't read lips from way in the back there. Thank you a lot. That was beautiful. We're going to get a movie double feature. We're going back to the movies for Eddie Young and doing the original Frank Sinatra arrangement, I'm told, of New York, New York. From a 1979 movie of the same name, in this case, the words do outshine the movie, probably, in most people's memory. This song has been redone. It's a true classic as recently as Lady Gaga, who is not quite the same as Frank Sinatra, but that pays tribute to good music. So, Eddie Young is going to also pay tribute.
One.
And we are going to hear him and the orchestra performing New York, New York.
Start spreading the news. I'm leaving today. I wanna be a part of it. New York, New York. Those vagabond shoes. How longing to stray. Right through the very heart of it. New York, New York. And find out king of the hill, top of the heap, those little town blues are melting away. I'll make a brand new start of it.
Start to get an influx of Yankee fans into the mix, or do you have to go a little further for that? All right, because New York, New York, okay, but this time of year we're thinking Boston, and when we look toward Boston, if we look on a summer night or on a winter night and you squint and you look really hard, you can see members of the New England Digital Accordion Orchestra who come from the Boston area to rehearse with this group. So I want to call them out from Eastern Massachusetts. So we've got Carmen D'Angelo from Stoneham. We've got Tony DeRamo from Ashland. We've got David Gamache from Belmont. And taking it a step further, going all the way to the Cape, we've got Charles Gruska from Harwich. Can you believe that? The guy leaves the Cape to come with us. And we're glad he did. So that was good. We're gonna kind of keep in that showbiz realm. although we do have to get these folks hydrated, for gosh sakes. They're working as hard as the people over on the soccer field, and I know that because I ref over here sometimes, and, you know, making music is work. So how are we doing, Sam? Can we introduce our piece? I'll drink to that. Never on Sunday. Opa! Classic from Zorba the Greek, just to mix things up a bit more for you. So give it a holler, and, you know, shuffle them feet. Get on up. Never on Sunday.
Thank you. we got more music for you. You know, I do want to give credit to everybody in this band. We've looked in the different states and everything else, and we looked at the beautiful sunset, and just know that riding off into this sunset, when we finally have to say goodnight, is Martha Flood, Adams, Massachusetts, and Bob Mazzola going up to Pittsfield. That's our Western Mass.
Martha!
Our neighbors in Central Mass, in the 508, James Avedisian, Milbury, Stanley Madura. I know that's not 508, but it's Gilbertville, Massachusetts, part of Harvard. Give it up for them. And we've got from the Upper Pioneer Valley, Barney Kratois from Granby. And Paul Block from Longmeadow is. Okay, that was a segue. Go ahead. Now he's got to earn it. Okay, because he's going to rise to the occasion with a traditional accordion strong suit. That is a medley of German music using the versatility of the digital accordion. Paul plays at the Munich House, or München, as we say in Germany, restaurant in Chicopee, and also with the famous, he has the accompaniment of full orchestra on a memory stick. We know that. And he plays with the Philadelphia Mummers Band. That's what I was going to say. Also, welcome your neighbor, just over the line, Bob Luck, a German medley. Part of that was actually a song my German teacher taught us in the 8th grade, and I got to see if it's the same song. That's incredible. Flashback. All right, besides Paul, we've got some other neighbors of yours, or neighboring townsfolk, that we'd like you to welcome tonight. So we have Mark Galica from Westfield, Massachusetts. John Camardella from Springfield, Massachusetts. We've heard of that town. It's somewhere near here. Angela, Daniel, and Michael Falsetti, all of Ludlow. Leah McCool of Wilbraham. Pat Taylor of Palmer, Massachusetts. We've got you surrounded, so we don't have anybody from this town. If you're interested in joining, talk to Sam.
Now, it's not often that the Beatles have a tough act to follow, but Michelle is as worthy a Beatles song to bring up here tonight, and it's a love ballad by Paul McCartney, John Lennon, and appears on the 65 album, 1965 Rubber Soul album by the Beatles. Soulful feel and even some French lyrics. And if anybody happened to catch the PBS show about how the way those guys wrote music recently, they really did employ some heavy-duty devices. With vocalist Eddie Young, the New England Digital Accordion Orchestra gives you Michelle.
Michelle, my belle, these are words that go together well. My Michelle, I love you, I love you, I love you. That's all I want to say. Until I find a lovely way, I will say the only words I know that you'll understand. I need you, I need you, I need you. I need to make you see, oh, what you mean to me. Until I do, I'm hoping you will know, know what I mean. I love you, I want you, I need you. I think you know by now. I'll get to you somehow. Until I do, I'm telling you so. You will understand.
In the case of Star Wars, let's face it, the music can't keep up. But there is an iconic piece that goes with Star Wars. It's in everybody's head as soon as you hear the name of the films. It's got New England connections. Oh, by the way, I did get an update before the Red Sox were ahead 4-0 over Toronto. I was going to point toward Boston. Well, I got a Canadian out there, eh? Anyway, John Williams, former Boston Pops conductor, director, did write this, composed this piece. The Star Wars theme, you're going to hear it as good as it gets, full out. Here we go.
Thank you.
going to make a sequel of that one tonight, however. We do have another sing-along opportunity if you are so inclined. Now, we have a traditional American spiritual that was first published in 1927. It took 30 years before folk music really made it well-known in our country. And there are many verses. But we owe a good deal of our musical heritage to these spirituals, and this is just one great example of that. He's got the whole world in his hands with the orchestra. Let's hear it. Dancers, among the most recognized form of traditional music you'll recognize from southern Italy. We want to keep the toes tapping, the hands clapping with an Italian tarantella. Sam, here we go to Italy again, which he does every year anyway. Is going to kind of pull a lot of that together. I think Sam has a few things, if you are Mike.
Thank you very much, Bob. It's such a pleasure to perform here in East Long Meadow. It's probably a dream come true. I've been to a lot of the concerts here in the past, and I I know you always get a good crowd, and they have probably the greatest of equipment, especially for this size band. It's not easy to set this band up. It's a very difficult, very complicated, all right, because there's many members of the band, and there's also many different sections of the band. So it's not an easy job to do. So I applaud the sound people, Artie and your crew. Al, what a great job. Great job and a great sound. I'd like to take a minute. You know, I retired from falsetto music about 8 or 9 years ago. I retired in the morning and I went back to work in the afternoon. But anyway, I said to my son Tony, he took over the business, I said, you know, your dad wants to continue with what I'm doing with Roland accordions, and I feel there's a big future in it, and I feel there's a sound out there that nobody else has found. This is the only digital accordion orchestra in the United States. The only. Many of my colleagues are still playing the accordion oompa oompa, which is okay because we did that with a lot of things. We blended the accordion sounds with the orchestral sounds. But if some of you are sitting out there and you're wondering, where are all these sounds? I hear banjos on the folk songs, American folk songs, then the next minute you know I hear lush strings, and then I hear all this. The difference between a digital accordion and any other instrument, I'm talking the piano, the organ, the synthesizer, the digital piano. When you strike a note, if you're playing a trumpet, you strike that note, you got a trumpet. If you put the volume up, you got a louder trumpet, right? Well, on the accordion, this is the only instrument that has bellows. We can do the armature and we can do the accents that they play on the trumpet with our bellows. Uh-huh. Also, we can do the bowing of the violin with the bellows. We can do the sounds of the horn. We can play staccato the way it should be played on the banjo parts and make them sound like a banjo. You can't do this on other instruments. So the Roland accordion is really unique. And unfortunately, about 3 months ago, we lost Mr. Kakahashi. He's the one who invented this. He was an absolute genius in the music business. And he had 5 or 6 years of labor inventing this instrument, and that was 12 years ago. But I wanted to take a minute, and I wanted to tell you all about it. And also, I want to compliment. These people come just once a month for a probably 3 to 4 hour rehearsal. And if you say, well, how do they get all these songs down? Well, what we do is when we get a song down, we record it. Then we put it in a Dropbox, and they take it out of their computer, put it on a flash drive, put the flash drive in their accordion, and they practice with the orchestra at home. You know, you can't really do this with hardly any of the other instruments. So they have an opportunity to practice with the band at home, and then when they come to rehearsal, they're well rehearsed on the instrument. But I personally want to thank all of them. They have the passion and the devotion, and they work so hard for me. God bless them. Give them another round of applause. Huh? And I will continue with what I'm doing because, you know, I'm not going to be around forever. But listen, I hope I'm still conducting this band when I'm 103. guess what? That's next year. No, I'm only kidding. Anyway, we're going to end with God Bless America. This is a piece written by John Francis Chyna, who hails from Chicopee, Massachusetts, and he's an absolute genius. He was at Hart College at 11 years old in the theory department. He had a full scholarship to Catholic University, Boston University, and Hart College of Music. He's taught all over the country. He's been a professor at 3 or 4 colleges. He has 10 books on the market. And this piece he wrote specifically for the orchestra. Everything else that we did of his arrangements, they were written for accordion years ago, and he went and he changed them and the horn parts and all the banjos and everything else. But this is the first one that he wrote. And this is a different kind of an arrangement. and he did it on God Bless America. And I hope you join us in singing with us. Okay, Bob.
Well, I really can't touch what Sam had to say. Because actually he covered it well better than I as far as the folks coming together. We want to thank you, actually. That's one thing we can do. This has been a great, great experience, and we would love to do it again. You may stand if you wish. You may sing if you wish. Join in. God bless America.
Sam Falsetti, all our soloists and players, thank you for welcoming us to your hometown.